In the scenes of escalating violence in eastern Ukraine, this one is particularly sobering. The Ukrainian riot police sent in to remove pro-Russian militants from the city of Donetsk were instead removed themselves, chased away, and later stripped of their shields, batons, even their bulletproof vests. The militants were left to bust down doors and shatter windows. Pro-Russian militants are steadily seizing control of communities across eastern Ukraine. The eastern city of Slavyansk is now under militants' control, as are local government sites from police headquarters to city halls in eight other eastern towns and cities. Ukrainian officials say they are powerless to stop the militants' advances. But demonstrating their growing fears, Ukraine's president introduced a military draft for all men 18 to 25. And Ukrainian soldiers guarding the parliament building in the capital, Kiev, are carrying out emergency drills. At home in Russia, Moscow's intervention in Ukraine is broadly popular. At rallies marking May Day, thousands marched in Moscow to show their support. U.S. officials say Russia's ultimate goal is unknowable. But some analysts see President Putin intending to undermine upcoming elections in Ukraine, possibly to lay the groundwork for an invasion.
Then the Russian government makes the case that the results of the elections are illegitimate, and then they have the right to protect the rights of those citizens in eastern Ukraine who they feel are, their rights are being violated. And that then is where I think the real danger for a possible military invasion of eastern Ukraine comes in.